pretty much get like all the tiles, kind of like Evolution, but like bunch of like European people. And then like at WrestleMania, the group splits and it's like a one-on-one match with Wade Barrett and Sheamus or something. And then after that, Triple H like returns from an injury or something, and then you attack Sheamus, and then something happens, and then the Miz injures you, and it says you're gone for 6 months, and then you come back at WrestleMania, and like the Miz becomes WWE champion or something, or retains or something like that. I don't, it's really stupid, and like most of the game doesn't even take place during the like WWE Road to WrestleMania thing. It's just like year round, but really stupid. Wasn't the game's full name SmackDown vs. Raw or something? I forget. My favorite WWE group ever is Nexus, the one with CM Punk. My favorite is Evolution. When it was good. When it was good. I'm gonna hit him with a weapon. Even the one with Barrett was good. Yeah. That's when I wasn't watching wrestling. Like I did not watch wrestling at the time whatsoever. And then I got back into wrestling when CM Punk did the whole like pipe bomb thing. That's why I went restarted watching wrestling. So I got back into it. Like I still played the games, but I did not care for the TV, like, 'cause it was just boring. Like right now it's pretty stupid, but I sometimes watch it when I have nothing to do. Like I haven't watched the one that aired last Monday or a few days ago. But sometime soon I'm probably gonna watch it, but I don't like I was watching the week before and it was the most like the most stupidest ending ever. It was like a cartoon ending. Yeah, push him away. It was like Seth Rollins like saying I'm gonna break the neck of Edge. And then like saying bring the authority back, John, or whatever, and then like John Cena's like fine, I'll bring the authority back. And then Seth Rollins is like, yes! Yes, they're back! Woohoo! Or whatever, and then like and then he goes, I'm gonna kill him anyway. And then like he goes to, like apparently break Edge's neck, but then like John Cena comes in and attacks him, which he could have did the entire time, which is one of the stupid things. And then like John Cena basically gets beat up or whatever, and then Seth Rollins walks away, and then come on, punch. He pretty much like Seth Rollins starts walking away with a bunch of other people, like Big Show's with him, and like two other people are with him. And then Brock Lesnar and Paul Heyman come out because Brock Lesnar is the WWE champion. And then out of nowhere, Triple H comes out and Stephanie McMahon, and they're like, they're already back. Like they've been there, which is just it was stupid. It was horrible. Like they should just totally forget everything and go back to the ways of what's it called? The ruthless aggression. 'Cause that was like the best time in my opinion. A bunch of people would say Attitude Era, but screw the Attitude Era. Stone Cold was cool, but you know, he was even, in my opinion, he was cooler in the aggression era or whatever. Ruthless aggression era, that's it. He was just way more entertaining, in my opinion. But that's when I grew up watching him. In my opinion, it was just way better. It's a way better time. See, I want to DQ myself, but actually, I want to win this match. So I'm doing pretty good. I thought I wasn't gonna be able to be doing this good. So now I'm gonna try and win. But yeah, that was my little rant on WWE today. It's pretty bad. Hell, that. The fake reality show Total Divas. Well, every reality show is fake. Like, Keeping Kardashians and Housewives, they're all fake. Everyone knows it. Stone Cold made the Attitude Era.
Yeah.
But I liked them more in the era that I grew up watching. When he was called the Sheriff and he was the GM of Raw, I just liked it better. Because it was my time, anyway.
I watched SmackDown more. I think I watched a lot SmackDown a lot more than Raw.
Even though, I don't know.
They were both really good, but like at that time, SmackDown was like
in my eyes, it seemed like the bigger brand.
Yeah, pick up the title.
Was that a title match?
I don't think that was.
I think I just always do a little taunt thing with the title when I'm champion.
I think I have no idea.
The Rock finished the Attitude Era?
I don't think so.
In a way, well, no. Now, here's the thing. Oh, yeah, that was a title defense. See, they do title defenses every single week. It's pretty dumb. But no, in a way, Shawn Michaels and The Undertaker and Bret Hart started the Attitude Era. Stone Cold, Shawn Michaels, The Rock, and DX made the Attitude Era really, really good. And Mick Foley, or Mankind at that time, made it, like, good and, like, relevant. And then, I would say The Rock, well, technically, Mr. McMahon started it. And then, I won't even really say who started the Ruthless Aggression era, but the people who made it good was like Eddie Guerrero, Evolution, Goldberg, Brock Lesnar, Undertaker, the biker one, which I like the biker Undertaker better. Great title defense tonight. You're not out of the woods yet, though. You have 3 more to go this month.
Okay.
Then, yeah. And then, the moment John Cena went to Raw, killed the Ruthless Aggression era. Just killed it. When he created the whole spinner belt, just killed, slit the throat of Ruthless Aggression era, which was my favorite era, and went into whatever the hell the other era is. Because right now, it's like, I don't even know what that era would... I don't even think that is an era. I think that's still considered Ruthless Aggression, but in my opinion, that's a whole nother era. In my eyes. Tommy Wall. That would be kind of funny to lose to this dude. I'm going to see my entrance with the title. I don't think I watched it. But yeah, and then the era after Ruthless Aggression was okay. With like Edge and the Money Bank, like the creation of the Money in the Bank match. Good era. It wasn't like, it's not my favorite. Probably my 3rd favorite, I guess. And after that, it just like crap. I loved Randy Orton's debut. Like, when he first appeared, I don't even know his debut. I know John Cena's debut. He came out in like pink trunks and he was talking to Kurt Angle and he's like, and like Kurt Angle's like, why are you here? What do you think you're gonna do or something? And then John Cena just like goes, Ruthless Aggression, and then like punches him in the face, and then they have a match. And then John Cena wins, and after that they do like, or no, I think the match starts, it goes like, who the hell are you? And he goes, John Cena, and then he punches him in the face. But then like the match, after the match, he like, I think he wins it. But in a... Is this Randy Orton? This is Randy Orton's entrance. That's funny. Like Randy Orton's entrance. Title entrance. That's pretty cool. But yeah. After the match, he's like backstage and then like, I think Jeff Hardy comes up to him or something. Let me just get that. Like someone comes up to him, I don't remember who, and goes, that was a pretty good match, man. And then, like, he stares and he goes, oh. And then, like, that dude walks away. And then Undertaker comes up and goes, that was a good match. And why do I suck? Are you talking about Mubot? Mubot sucks? I like Tommy Wong. He's probably my most favorite generic dude created by the game. But who sucks? I suck? Oh, wait. Are you doing a Kurt Angle thing? You're doing a Kurt Angle thing. Oh, you suck. You suck. You suck. You suck. Kurt Angle's probably one of my favorite wrestlers. Probably when it comes to wrestling, Kurt Angle, Eddie Guerrero, Chris Benoit. Yeah, Kurt Angle's thing. Took me a minute to think of it. For a second, I was like, why does he say I suck? But, you know, I had to think of it because I said Kurt Angle. But yeah, when it comes to wrestlers, like legit, like wrestling, like the in-ring entertainment, it's got to be, for me, Kurt Angle, Chris Benoit, and Eddie Guerrero. Favorite, like, wrestling wrestlers. And Shawn Michaels. It was always fun to watch his matches. And then, when it comes to entertainment, it would probably be Stone Cold, The Rock, Stone Cold, Rock. Eddie also, he was a pretty good entertainer. Chris Benoit was bad. Kurt Angle was okay. But also, The Rock and Stone Cold were good wrestlers too. I just like the physicalness that Eddie, Chris Benoit, and Kurt brought to the table when it comes to The Rock and Stone Cold. They just did, you know, like generic suplex and stuff. They didn't do any like fancy like German stuff, from what I've seen at least. But they're probably like my top five wrestlers, or six. I think I named six. Chris Benoit, Kurt Angle, Eddie Guerrero, what's his name? Stone Cold, Rock. That's five, right? Then he went crazy and killed his family. Yeah. See, now here's a quote that I saw from on YouTube. This is a quote I saw on YouTube that I really liked, and that I also agree with. Illuminati, stupid. But the quote that I agree with is that some random comment on YouTube said was, now what Chris Benoit did was horrible, but he was a great wrestler. For me, I respect the wrestler, not the person. I respect the wrestler Chris Benoit. Screw the person. You know, I've also seen videos of like, you know, beside of, like, other wrestlers who was friends with Chris Benoit, they're all, like, saying things like, you know, Chris was a great guy, he was funny, he was such a loving guy, he would do anything for you, you know. And, like, they have, like, no idea why he did it, which, no one does, in a way. But, you know, but I like the thing that I liked on, that I saw on WWE, not what I saw on the news and articles and whatnot. I just like the character Chris Benoit, not the person. I've never met the person, but I've played as the character in video games, and he stole my signature. Nobody didn't get it. Huh. Maybe he doesn't steal it, he just like gets rid of it, and just like body slammed onto his knees. Ugh. Blah! Now I'm a taunt. I think taunting is actually a good guy thing. Which it shouldn't, but I think it is. In this game, at least. But I really liked... Recently, right before Christmas, I refound my SmackDown vs. Raw. And I played that. Who did I play as? I think I played as Chris Benoit, actually. Yeah, I think I played as Chris Benoit in SmackDown vs. Raw when I played it right before Christmas. And I beat the entire game, like, at WrestleMania, the whole storyline was I was world champion. And then, I was world champion, and then Undertaker was the WWE champion, and we were going to have a match to...